So the next topic we will take up is coral reefs. Coral reefs are landforms, remember. Coral reefs kya hai? They are landforms. Okay, they are marine landforms. This is the most important first word. Landforms formed from the accumulation of remains of dead marine organism, skeletons. Okay, they're made up of remains of dead marine organism skeletons. These organisms are called as coral polyps. Okay, they are landforms formed from the accumulation of remains of dead marine organism skeletons. The organisms are called as coral polyps. And they comprise, they comprise calcium carbonate. They comprise calcium carbonate. Isme lime hota hai. Calcium carbonate, bones essentially. Bones, they pile up. So this is the maybe floor of the ocean. On this, the skeleton will pile up. And this kind of becomes one type of a landform. Okay, this is the ocean water, under the water ho sakte hain. Okay, and they become the landforms. This is the key word, okay? What are the types of coral reefs? What are the types? So, some of the common are called as fringing reefs. Fringing, the word fringing ka matlab hota hai margins. So what are these? These are along the borders. These are along the margins of the coast, margins of islands. So agar ye island hai, it's an island here, along the margins here, ekdam saath mein lagkar, along the margins here, this is the coast here, along the margins here, these are called as fringing, F-R-I-N-G-I-N-G. They are called as fringing reefs. They along the margins of the coast, margins of the islands. And these are the most common types. These are the most common types of reefs. The second type of reefs, okay, they are called as barrier reef. Barrier reef are elongated, they are wide, they are extensive, okay, ridge like formations. Anybody knows what's the meaning of the word ridge? Ridge means like a mountain hoga. They're elongated, they are wide, they're extensive, and they are mountain like formations. They're like long, continuous, okay, mountain-like formations. So, what do they look like? So, agar ye land hai, and say this is the ocean here, this is the land here. So, somewhere away from the land, they're not exactly along the margins, so away on the land, okay, somewhere here maybe. So, they have piled up, and this has become a barrier reef. Okay. If it is a fringing reef, then this is the land, this is the water here. Fringing reefs ekdam margins mein hote hain. These are fringing reefs, right at the margins of the water, at the coast. These are further away. Aur ye jo water hai, this is a shallow water. Okay, the barrier reefs are what? They're long, elongated, extensive, ridge-like formations. This is the top, you're looking from top. वैसे अगर ये लैंड है, this is the land here. If you look from top, this is the fringing reef. The barrier reefs are further away. like elongated ridges like this. This is a barrier reef. Looking from top, the barrier reef looks like an elongated mountain. Barrier reefs are the largest reefs. These are the largest systems. And one example of this, I'm sure you know, what's called as the Great Barrier Reef. Suna aapne? The largest one is the Great Barrier Reef. Yes. The third type of reefs. These are called as atolls. These are the most interesting ones and these are the most intriguing ones. Okay, atolls. Atolls are what? They are a circular or they are near circular. They are circular or near circular. Okay, ring-like formation. Okay, very importantly, they are in the open oceans. Okay, they are much thicker accumulations. They are circular, near circular rings like formation. They are in the open oceans. They are much thicker accumulations. And they enclose again shallow lagoons. Okay. What are lagoons? Lagoons are shallow lakes along the coast, which have salt water. They are shallow lakes along the coast, which have salt water. Okay? So they enclose shallow lagoons. So if you look from top, this is the coral accumulations, almost circular. These are accumulations, almost circular. They're almost circular, closed almost. Aur ye jo water hai beech mein, this is the lagoon. Okay, if you look at the cross section, the vertical cross section will look something like this. So this is the lagoon. This is the coral reef. This is the coral reef. Ye ocean water hai. This is the lagoon. Can you all imagine here? Why they are closed? That's one of the biggest mysteries. Yes, barrier reefs are more large. They are more extensive. They have got more length and width. But atolls are more thicker. This thickness is more in case of atolls. They are much, much thicker. Examples of these, you have got these island groups. Seychelles hai. Maldives hai, Lakshadweep islands, the many islands of the Caribbean Sea, the islands of Southwest Pacific. All of these are largely atolls. Seychelles, Maldives, Lakshadweep islands, Caribbean islands, yes, many islands of Southwest Pacific, small islands wahan par hain. Many of them are atolls. They are very low-lying. Themselves are islands. So these are the atolls. So apart from this, the other type of coral reefs, one is called as patch reef, P-A-T-C-H. Patch reefs, as the name suggests, they're like small patches. Okay, so there is a patch here. A patch here, a patch here. They're very small ones, patch reefs. Or again, they are tall, slender accumulations. These are called as pinnacles, P-A-N-N-A-C-L-E-S. They're called as pinnacles. Patch reefs, they're like small patches which are scattered, and tall, thin reefs, they are called as pinnacles. So fringing reefs are right along the margins here. You can see the margins here, fringing reef. These are further away, thadur mein hai. Land is here, these are very far away. These are called as the barrier reefs. And they almost become circular rings like this. They're called as atolls. This is a typical atoll you can see here. It's an atoll. It's all there on the net. Okay, fringing reef, this is better one. The mountain here, along the margins of the mountain, ye hai fringing reef. Thoda sa dur hai, this is the barrier reef, further away from the land. Or beach mein, there are shallow waters here. And atolls are almost circular rings. They're almost circular rings. We call these as atolls. Now let's move on. Now, how are these reefs formed? Like, what is the mechanism, okay? Formation of coral reefs. Coral reefs. Now, I've told this to you that these are the skeletal remains. These are the skeletal remains of marine microorganisms. Okay, these are the skeletal remains of the marine microorganisms. And what are these called? They're called as the coral polyps. They're called coral polyps. Now, there is a typical reason how they grow. Okay, into coral polyps. They exist, they survive in a symbiotic relationship with algae called zooxanthellae. Zooxanthellae. Okay, right on this point. The coral polyps, they exist, they survive in symbiotic relationship with algae called as zooxanthellae. Do you understand what I mean by symbiotic relationship? Iska meaning pata hai aapko? Symbiotic ka matlab kya hai? Is also called as mutualism. Yes. Both are benefited. There is an organism called as A. There is an organism called as B. A helps B and B helps A. So this is called as mutualism. Mutualism, also called as symbiosis. Mutualism, also called as symbiosis. So the relationship between the corals and the algae. Okay, this is a kind of a relationship which is called as mutualism or symbiosis. So what happens is the coral polyps, are like animals. They are like animals. They are heterotrophs. Anybody knows what are heterotrophs? Heterotrophs do not prepare their own food. Okay, they need other life forms to prepare their food. Man, okay, is a heterotroph. Okay, carnivores are heterotroph, not parasite. They are heterotrophs. Parasite in general is one type of heterotroph. Okay, anything that does not prepare their own food, this does not prepare their own food. Okay. Now, coral polyps live with zooxanthellae, and the zooxanthellae, these can perform photosynthesis. These can perform photosynthesis. The zooxanthellae are a colorful. Okay, zooxanthellae, the presence of zooxanthellae attracts other life forms that corals feed on. Okay, they live with zooxanthellae. The coral themselves don't prepare food. They live with zooxanthellae. The zooxanthellae performs photosynthesis. The zooxanthellae themselves are very, very colorful. They can be red in color, they can be yellow in color, they can be blue in color, they can be orange in color, very colorful. Okay. And the presence of zooxanthellae. Ab kya ho raha hai? Zooxanthellae, they prepare food. The zooxanthellae also are colorful. They attract other life forms. That corals, now corals ka typical kya hota hai? The corals typically have fingers like this, the fingers. The fingers are called as tentacles. Tentacles, the corals ke fingers hote hai. And on the body of the corals, there is zooxanthellae. On the body of the corals, there is zooxanthellae. Okay, zooxanthellae prepare food. The zooxanthellae are colorful. So marine organisms come near. The marine organisms, they come near. Or come near. And these finger, like tentacles, they grab. Okay, so they can grab the small, small life forms. So the relationship is what? The corals give the zooxanthellae place to live. The zooxanthellae are on the body of the corals. Or zooxanthellae kya karta hai? Zooxanthellae, it prepares food, it attracts other life forms that the corals will feed on. That's why we call this is the type of a symbiosis relationship. This is the type of mutualism. Tentacles ka matlab hota hai, like fingers. Tentacles like fingers. Okay, they will grab. Okay, so this is a coral reef. Think of my hand as a coral life form, like octopus. Okay, octopus is big arms, small ones. Think of this as a coral, okay, with tentacles. On the body of the corals, there are zooxanthellae, there are algae here. They're present here, they prepare food, so they become rich, nice, colorful. Small organisms come near it, and this one will grab it and consume the food. Now, corals can't move. Corals, they are like animals, but they are sedentary. Okay, corals can't move. They require some platforms to grow on. Okay, important point. So, next point here is that coral polyps, okay, need the following conditions. They need the following conditions to grow. Okay. To grow and survive. So, kya conditions hai? Number one, they require saline waters. They require warm waters. Corals, okay, cannot survive. Corals cannot survive beyond the photic limit. What I mean by photic limit? Okay, the depth up to which the sunlight can penetrate is called as the photic limit. Photic limit generally is how much? It's approximately 100 fathoms or about equal to 200 meters. But the important point is, healthy corals are generally within 30-40 fathoms, and they rarely survive beyond 80 fathoms. I'm sorry, 30-40 meters. I'm sorry. They are generally not fathoms, meters. They are generally within 30-40 meters and they rarely survive beyond 80 meters. Okay, so I'm saying that photic zone ke beyond to possible nahin hai. So if this is the water here, ye water hai. Okay, so this is the photic zone up to which sunlight can penetrate. Iske beyond impossible hai. But look at the reality. Bulk of the corals are within 30-40 fathoms. And beyond 80 meters, it is very, very rare. It's very, very rare. Photic means the sunlight zone. They cannot survive beyond. Anybody can tell me why they can't survive beyond this? Why they can't survive beyond this? Why? Because zooxanthellae can't survive. Zooxanthellae requires sunlight for photosynthesis. Correct. So, jahan par sunlight nahi hai, the zooxanthellae can't survive, and therefore the corals also can't survive. But the reality is, the healthy corals are generally within 30-40 meters, and they rarely survive beyond 80 meters. Okay? So they require saline waters, they require warm waters. They cannot survive beyond the photic limit, but then I've added something. And beyond 80 meters, bahut kam ho jata hai. Because what happens is, beyond 80 meters, the water becomes a bit more cooler. Beyond 80 meters, the salinity also starts changing. Beyond 80 meters, other conditions will start changing. Okay? So this is an important point. And another very important point here is, that corals are not swimmers. The corals are not swimmers. They are not floaters. They don't float. They don't swim. The fishes swim, right? Fishes swim. They don't float. Planktons. Planktons are again microorganisms that can float. Corals are not floaters, correct? They are not swimmers. They are not floaters. So what are they? They require platforms. They require surfaces. Surfaces to grow on. They require platforms and they require surfaces to grow on. Okay? They rarely survive beyond 80 meters. Corals are not swimmers. Corals are not floaters. They require platforms or surfaces to grow on. So, if this is the seawater level, and these are the underwater relief, and think of this as approximately 100 meters the depth. Okay, so A, B, C, D, E, and this could be 200 meters depth. E, F, G, H, I, J. Okay. Think of this. Yeh water level hai. Yeh water level hai. Yahan par. And this is the underwater relief. Can tell me where all will the coral survive? On which places? Okay. Will the coral survive? G, H, I, J, K, L, M. Where can the coral survive? Now listen, coral can't be at C, can't be at D. Why? Because beyond 100 meters, bahut kam chance hai. Even if agar photic zone hai, tab bhi, a very less chance. They can't be here. Okay. They can't be here. They can't be here. Okay. Yahan par bhi bahut kam chances hai. They can be here. They can be here. They can be here. They are again less likely here. They will not be here. Okay. Can they be here? No, because this is above the water. Yahan bhi nahi ho sakta. They're under the water. They're here. So these are the corals. Okay. These could be the corals. Iske upar mein, these are the corals. Yahan pe koi platform hi nahi hai. Nothing here. These are the corals maybe. I hope you got the point here. Okay. So where all can corals survive? The corals can survive in warm waters. Corals can survive in the cold water, in the sunlight regions. Corals require saline waters. Corals require platforms. And the platform should be at depths where the sunlight can reach, because we need the zooxanthellae to survive also. Okay, they require platforms to survive. And very importantly, I said that survive below the high tide level. Okay? Because for some times, the corals can remain above the water. Okay? But beyond a point, they can't survive. Okay? So, agar ye land hai, this is high tide, this is low tide. Jo corals honge, wo yahan tak honge. So in the low tide, when the water comes down, the corals get exposed, but for some time, ultimately, again, the water rises up, okay, and they're under the water. They'll survive just below the high tide level. What are the conditions for the corals? Corals require saline waters. They require saline waters. They require warm waters. They cannot survive beyond the photic limit. Generally, they are within 30, 40 meters. Okay, and they very rarely survive beyond 80 meters. Both rare hai. And then I explained, okay, the corals require platforms. The corals require platforms. Okay, and the fifth point we said was that the corals, they can survive just below the high tide levels. They can survive just below the high tide levels. Yes, iska bhi limits hai. Limits kya hai? Okay, the temperature hai, the warm waters, the temperatures hai, the temperatures are around 27 degrees centigrade. Isse kam nahi hona chahiye, and it should not be more than 30 degrees centigrade. Saline waters, then in the range of 34, 35 parts per thousand. Your books will mention 33, but keep it at 34, 30. Five parts per thousand ke range mein, not very very salty, okay, and not less salty. This is the range of temperature generally. So 27 is considered to be a very good temperature for them to survive. Which implies, if you put all the conditions together, corals are found in the tropical waters. They found tropical waters. Corals are not found in the eastern tropical because of upwelling waters. They are in the tropical waters, but not in the eastern tropical waters. Why? The eastern tropical waters will have upwelling.